Okay, the very latest valveless chromatic on the market is the Eastop 4Runner. Now this one's actually probably more suitable for most chromatic players because it's got a full 3-octave range and every octave is the same as you'll find on a standard 12-hole chromatic. And also the slider system is the same as is used on standard Eastop chromatics, Suzuki chromatics, Hohner chromatics. So it's an easy one to adjust to for people used to the standard 12-hole 3-octave chromatic. But instead, in terms of installing my gasket valves, the procedure is the same as for the 10-hole chromatics. So let me just show you how to do it. Well, as you can see, there's the the two inner gasket valves, the two outer gasket valves, reed plates, comb. You can see this comb of the 4Runner is actually very similar to the 10-hole valveless chromatics. Okay, but we're going to start with the inner gasket valves on the reed plates here. And as with them, we want to look at the side of the reed plates where the reed plates are facing in. That's where the gasket valve is going to be stuck down. And we also want to make sure that we get the gasket valves oriented correctly. So if I pick this one up and put it on this reed plate, you'll see that the curvature of the valve is not correct. It's actually facing away from the reed plate. It's quite easy to see, really. There's a curvature on the gasket valve. So that's not the right way. What we want to do is get where the curvature is facing down towards the reed plate. And this ensures that the valves will stay down. Now, as with the 10-hole chromatics, we need to wet the inside of the reed plate there in order to hold everything in place just long enough in order to get the harmonica assembled with the screws. And as before, I'm just going to lick my reed plate. I mean, as I said before, if you're squeamish about that, you can get a sponge and wet it. The main thing is get some liquid on the plate so that you get the effective capillary attraction holding down the gasket valve onto the reed plate. Okay, so here we go. And get your gasket valve and just position it on the reed plate so that all the reeds are clear of the and there it is. You can see that once it's in there, all the holes are lined up, all the valves are lined up. It's just so easy. So here we go, we've got the other surface where the reeds are facing in, and we get the other gasket valve. Again, lick the plate and use the capillary attraction to hold the gasket valve in place. Just, adjust it a little bit, press it down so that it's sitting snugly, and you can see all the valves are nicely lined up, all the holes are lined up. Okay, so this is the one. There's the upper reed plate and the lower reed plate. The lower reed plate has got the is where the screws are going to be screwed in. So we take the harmonica, that's the upper side, that's the lower side, and we get the lower reed plate and carefully lift it with its gasket valve in place and just gently put it down on the comb and hold it in place. Okay, turn it over. Now we get these two cover plate spacers and slip them through the slots in the reed plate, which you can see through those little holes there. Okay, and then carefully get your upper reed plate and holding everything in place, just maneuver it so that these two cover plate spacers, this is the trickiest part, slip through the slots in the reed plate. Okay, that's the worst of it over. Then get a couple of reed plate screws, pop them down like that, and then just don't screw them whole all the way, just tack them in place so that everything's kind of not going to shift around. Okay, now you just get your other screws. Holes, and then just tighten up your reed plate screws. I'm starting from the inside and progressively moving outwards. This sort of spreads the pressure out from the inside, and it's sort of standard procedure when you're tightening up any screwed down plate. Stops buckling of the plate. Okay, so there you go. There are three more screws to put in there, but I'll leave them aside for the moment. So then we get our outer gasket valve, and this is the one with the big holes. You see there's one with small holes, one with big holes. So on the top we get the one with the big holes, and we just line these holes in the outer gasket valve, and we just press them down so they just press over the, whoops, don't worry about that, that's just the these things going through the cardboard on the bottom here. Press them so they just press over the screws and they're held in place. Okay, now you can see that the outer valves are just perfectly lined up there, and then we get the other one. We do the same on the other side. We just put these little holes, and they will just press down over the screw ends. Whoops, that's just these things going through the cardboard, don't worry. Okay, so now basically the thing is fully valved and we can play it. Okay, so it's solo tuned, and it plays exactly the same as a standard chromatic. And you'll be amazed at the difference in performance of the 4Runner with my gasket valves installed as opposed to the 4Runner without gasket valves. It makes a huge difference. Okay, the final thing to do with the 4Runner is to put these tiny little front screws on. So when you disassemble it, make sure not to lose these, because they are really tiny little screws, and they actually tap into the comb. Okay, so I'm actually using tweezers to hold them in place, which is kind of an easy way to locate them and just make sure that they're in the right place. Now there are three more on the other side, but I've gone and lost one, so I'm going to put just two of these on. Probably put these two on. So there we go, there's a cautionary tale. I've lost one of those tiny screws already, so try not to do the same as me. There we go. But the harmonica will still play fine, even though it's only got two of those screws on the front. Okay, so the final thing to do is simply to put your cover plates on. There's your top cover plate, bottom cover plate. So there's your top cover plate. The name on. Sit it in place. Get your bottom cover plate. Sit that in place. And then get one of these longer female screws and just kind of hold that in position. And then get one of the male screws and gently locate that in the other screw and just lightly screw it in, then get the other one. Just have a look down, see if you can see where it is, and it's a little bit, can be a bit tricky, but locate the metal screw there, and then just kind of have a look at everything and see if it's looking all pretty even, and then you can tighten up your cover plate screws. There you go, you have an Eastop 4Runner, which is now fully valved. And that will play as well, if not better than, a standard Eastop 12-hole chromatic or many other good quality chromatics on the market that, you know, cost a lot more money than the 4Runner.